Dear students, you have already learnt about the classical theories, about the various theories you have learnt: classical, neoclassical, postmodern. So today you would be learning about the emerging approaches to city development, and there are various approaches, from eco-cities to livable cities, to green cities, to resilient cities, to low carbon cities, to sustainable cities, smart cities, safe cities. So there are so many approaches. So one after another, let us understand what they are all about. We start with the eco-cities. An eco-city is an ideal habitat where nature and technology merge, human creativity and productivity reach a maximum level, residents' health and environmental quality are well protected, and energy, materials and information are efficiently used. There is another definition which says that eco-city is a city that provides an acceptable standard of living for its human occupants without depleting the ecosystems and biochemical cycles on which it depends. Now, eco-city concept, where did it come from and when did it start? So the eco-city concept, this eco-city approach, the roots of this concept was in the book of Ian McCaug, a landscape architect who in 1969 had written the book Design with Nature. So the concept of this eco-city was written by him, and it is basically an ecological planning approach. Richard Register introduced this term eco-city in 1987 in his book Eco-City Berkeley, Building Cities for a Healthy Future. What are the characteristics of the eco-city? So Yang had put seven characteristics. The first is health and harmony, that is healthy human support system to provide consistent ecosystem services. Second is efficiency and vigor, that is environmentally friendly development modes and energy and materials used with maximum efficiency. Third is low carbon orientation, that is low carbon development for combating the challenge of climate change, aiming for higher resource productivity and developing new technologies. The fourth is sustaining prosperity, that is about shared prosperity, that is resources located in a specially equitable manner, sustained for future generations. The fifth is about ecological civilization, that is about harmonious symbiosis between human with human, between human with nature, and between human and society. The sixth is about holism, that is integrating, that is a more holistic perspective, integrating multiple factors, that is, or aspects, that is social, economic and environmental. And the last, or the seventh, is regionality, that is optimal urban development mode based on regional conditions. Now, what are the principles of this system or this approach? So one can see that there are four principles or eco-city principles, and those are: one is healthy urban ecosystem, that is ensuring enough ecosystem services for human health and maintenance of services; urban ecological security, that is ensuring basic human demands for living and social order; then efficiency and vigor, ensuring efficiency in consumption of energy and materials and promoting vigorous economic productivity. Now the next principle is about environmental capacity and sustainability, that is ensuring that development considers environmental capacity and there's the needs of future generations are met, are not compromised by the present generations' consumption patterns.